part of me knew it was going to be hard to make a living from writing. And I thought it would be easier to make a living from illustration. So I really kind of treated illustration as the trade. That was going to be my job while I made a living, you know, became a writer, which is daft, really, because illustration is every bit as hard.
I was, like, crazy about caricature, and I was doing a lot of, well, caricaturing my teachers, mainly. And then in college, I was introduced to a lot of graphics stuff. I studied graphic design. I just suddenly realized, wow, you can do these graphic, colorful shapes with all this expressive hand-drawn stuff as well. And that was like really kind of eureka. It's like, wow, that's exactly what I want to do.
Well, a lot of the stories that I have illustrated or written and illustrated have been for younger children. So when I'm starting, I usually start the story by thinking about the character. I will draw them a lot then and try to get an idea through the drawings of what they like and what they don't like and things that they do and if they have a family or where they live. So that kind of thing, you know, kind of develops as the drawings go on.
I do everything backwards, I think. I draw the story before I write it, and, you know, I do everything backwards. There's no logic to it at all.
I'll look at variety. I'll say, right, if I'm going to have a picture of one thing, I want something different in one of the other pictures. I want a contrast. I don't want two pictures, for instance, or three pictures with one guy's head, you know, just stuck in the middle of the picture. I want, if we've got a close-up of somebody's face, I want the next one to be happening in different kind of settings.
I've been working as an illustrator for the last sort of 10 years and doing lots of like illustrations for different people are asking me to do drawings and stuff. Everybody I've worked with, I think I've learned something from. My editor for these books is David Lloyd, and he worked for 12 years as a clown. And so he was touring around the UK as a clown, and he's the best person I know for reading out books.
I think practice is so important, and I think just having a, if you're able to draw as much as you can and spend as much time maybe looking at other people's work and getting ideas and thinking about how what you like in their work could work in yours as well.
Draw lightly, because I when I'm drawing in front of kids, I always make the point that we start off lightly with a pencil. We don't try and draw a perfect drawing, because what they see when they see a book illustration is they see the finished thing, and you don't see the sketchy bit. We hide that away. It's cheating, I know. But we will draw a really, really clean, finished picture on a new sheet of paper, or sometimes I'll even do it on computer. But you have to start off nice and loose and light so that you can rub the pencil out, because we all make mistakes, that's fine.
All of the inspiration really is from some sort of, not accident, but some, he's stumbling upon something and then having the freedom to kind of go, wait a minute, that's a good idea. I'd love to do something more with that.
A lot of times I'll kind of work on a drawing and then set it aside, and there might be some printmaking colours next to it. And then so the next time I come back to it and I'll see it sitting there with those, and I'll think, oh, that actually might work nicely together. But it really is quite spontaneous sometimes.
That's a very important part of the whole process of doing any sort of design, is to sort of leave yourself a little bit open, that when something unusual happens that looks good, you can then incorporate that into the finished picture.